Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding is a Dalit Muslim alliance possible, written by Faisal Devji. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science and sociology optional students. Now this editorial is about Muslim politics. This is also about how there has been a kind of non-existence of the Muslim politics. This editorial is also about how Muslims, they need to be more conscious about their political rights rather than just about their religious rights in order to become a political entity in themselves. Now when you take the case of Indian political system, religion has been the most important factor in deciding politics. Since the times of the Britishers, it was the religion that was at the forefront. After religion, there has been a kind of transition, and this transition has been towards the caste. The caste has begun to play a more predominant role after 1930s. Before 1930s, it was almost a politics of religion. Religion means a politics between the Muslims and the Hindus. From 1930s, we see a kind of a very significant change in the Indian political system, whereby the things begin to be decided by the system of caste. The Hindu system of Chaturvarna system was criticized, and it was also criticized how the Vaishyas and the Shudra communities have been exploited by the Brahmanas and the Kshatriyas, and how both these communities should wedge with each other, should wedge together in order to become a kind of a political force in themselves. Now, after so many years, we have seen the politics with regard to the Hindus, it has intensified, it has actually fractured, it has created its own fodders. Numerous fault lines has been created in the entire Hindu electorates. So the Hindu electorates, they have actually been divided into number of parts. But we have not seen this kind of division taking place in the Muslim community. Now why that has not happened? अगर आप मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी को देखते हो, मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी एक अपने आप में एक बहुत छोटा कम्युनिटी है रिलेटिवली टू द हिंदू कम्युनिटी, एंड दिस कम्युनिटी वाज ऑलवेज ट्रीटेड एज अ होमोजेनस ग्रुप टिल नाउ. दिस कम्युनिटी वाज प्लेकेटेड, दिस कम्युनिटी वाज सपोर्टेड, दिस कम्युनिटी वाज सकर्ड बाय द कांग्रेस. बट ऑफ लेट what we are witnessing is a new kind of churning taking place in Indian politics. What churning I am talking about? A churning about the Dalits and the Muslims liaison. Churning about a collaboration. Churning about a cooperation. Churning about a coordination between the Muslim electorate and the Dalit electorate. Now when we talk about this unison, when we talk about this marriage between the Dalits and the Muslims, the main question that comes to mind, is this marriage viable or not? Is this marriage sustainable or not? Or what should be done in order to create this support system more substantive? How can we create this marriage to sustain for a longer period of time? For that case, Muslims, they need to become more conscious about the political aspects. So what is meant by this thing that the Muslim needs to be more conscious about their political aspects? It means that the Muslims that are lying at the lower strata, lower level, lower hierarchy of the society, they need to create a kind of a consciousness among themselves about their political rights. What kind of political rights? The right to have more resources, right to have more and better livelihood things, right to for representation in the jobs, right for the representation in the employment, Now when you take this entire Muslim community, it is again a fractured community. It is again a divided community. But these divides, these fractures, these fault lines have not been exploited politically. They have not been used politically. And until and unless this exploitation, I won't call it exploitation, until and unless this division is not taken care of by the political leaders in the Muslim community, this entire community will begin to be treated as a homogeneous group, and this kind of unison will not be possible. Unison between the lower strata of the Muslims and the Dalits will be possible only if the leaders from the Muslim community will come forward. Now currently what we are having is just MIM. Now it is the Owaisi brothers who are just guiding the entire Muslim community in India. You don't have a kind of a very substantive alternative for these Owaisis. Though they are trying to project this Muslim community more as a political entity rather than as a religious entity. But we need to wedge this, we need to divide this Muslim community politically in order to do the Muslim politics. And this Muslim politics will create a kind of an alternative electorate to the collaboration and the coordination that is taking place between the Brahmanas and the Vaishyas. Because this is the strategy of the BJP party, to form a collaborative system between the Brahmanas and the Vaishyas and a part of the Kshatriyas. So rest of the communities like the Shudras, the Muslims and the part of the Kshatriyas, they can form an alternative part of the electorate that can be used to confront the wrong forces, that can be used to entrench democracy, that can be used to entrench accountability, that can be used to entrench responsibility from the government. See, any good political system is one in which you have numerous voices. Numerous voices means the voices for the people who want to have their rights get addressed. And to have these voices, to strengthen these voices, you need to create kind of support systems. You need to create collaborations. You need to create coordinations. Ultimately, democracy is all about the voice of the people. How effectively you create your voice, how effectively you put forward your voice, how effectively you get your voice heard. So this is all about democracy. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845940000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes, please visit our website brainyias.com. And you can also contact me at my WhatsApp number 845940000. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice night.